Friday, and it is semi-final day. The first seed is going at the moment. Crazy, actually, because Jordan was in the top 10, but he got COVID. Cannot compete, and the 11th guy can compete now, which is Jean-Yves, the French guy. Stoked for him. We'll watch the first seed and try to make it into finals. Woo.
He's got the thumbs up. Going for that. Into that McNasty.
Woo!
Into the back serve, that offside McNasty. Still staying retained, doing a roll as well. Just getting a lift.
Well, that wasn't a great ride for Dane. Hopefully he gets a better one on his second one. It's two rides, best one count.
He's used to finding a really
good
McNasty staying retained. Trying to get that back loop on the buzzer. Into a McNasty.
We're gonna cheer on Tom Dolly, and we have the mom, and we have all the supporters. Right now we don't know what's happening. He's out of his boat. Maybe it's not his turn. He's too early. Oh no, the other one is too early too. Oh, there's a break. Oh shit. I think I've said too much S's, but no matter. He's in the 80, looking good. Tom is in the final. We lost two Frenchies on the way through, but see you there.
I'm gonna go back to the athlete lounge and get some rest before the kayak semis.
Next up, we've got the young Tom Dole of France from his second competition as a senior man, our current C1 world champion, one of my absolute favorite paddlers to watch. Here we go, Tom dropping in as he goes for that entry three, linking it right into the McNasty, getting the air bonus on that, not stopping as he goes for the lunar orbit. Oh my gosh, unfortunately just passed.
All right, now this individual coming from upstream, he knows he's nowhere near. He knows, you know what, I'm C1 champ for a reason. I was junior champ for a reason. I'm gonna be senior champ. That's what he wants to tell. And so
one of the best all-around paddlers in the world, about to throw it down here to earn his place in a final. Entry, wing over, going for the lunar orbit, trying to link it into the loop, somehow managing to save that on his bow as he goes for the lunar orbit back in, trying to get the woo tricky, I believe that was a trick we have not seen, a reverse initiated split wheel into a Space Godzilla with a huge air loop. Here we go, Tom Dole going for that McNasty, getting the air on that trick. Tom just spinning it around as he goes for that next McNasty, seamlessly working the feature, moving move to move, 10 seconds left. He still has some points to pick up, maybe just missing that tricky woo. We'll have to see if the judges liked it as he goes for the Space Godzilla to the left. Can he get one more trick? He is not sure.
I tell you what, usually you see a trophy move toward the end of a ride. That's a real common place. They paddlers feeling good, they're throwing down. Right at the end of the ride, they go, this whole thing went right. I'm going to throw a trophy worth lots of points. Tom, right in the middle of the ride, said, you know, I'm going to go for a woo tricky, maybe a woo tricky with a loop, which would be a tricky loop or a woo tricky loop.
A woo tricky with cheese.
Woo tricky with cheese there.
Woo tricky loop. Woo tricky loop, see Tom.
All right,
but
10:26. Let's put him in fourth place.
All right, boys. Semi-finals. First heat just go. Harry Price is in first with 1,300 points. So Dan's gonna beat 1,300. I'm sure he's gonna go big. Got it, boss. How was the big loop contest, DJ?
Super fun, super fun. Watch some more big loops right now.
Drop into this thing. Straight into a window. Straight into a window.
So Thomas did the exact same right as Dane, which is 1,393 points. So they are both on two and second. Rob is still first. And now it's David's turn. He is currently not in the top five at the moment. And if he does a good ride, then he's gonna kick Kim out of the final. Let's see if he can hold the pressure. At least the Irish crowd is on fire.
Looking for a high-scoring ride. Straight into the entry, McNarth. No messing about. Into a little loop. Goes to left, a little bit there. Into a space in the other direction.
David can hold the pressure, I guess. He did a savage ride. He did almost a 1600 point ride, which is for sure gonna be in front of Kimmit and probably on the leader place. Kim is gonna be out of the final, and that's a bummer for him. It's been a while since he didn't make finals, I think.
Fais nous un petit truc stylé là.
French team is on fire for Tom!
Andy making me look good.
World Freestyle Championships here in Nottingham. Congratulations.
Final day at the World Championships, and it is the junior women final. All the girls did one ride, and it's not very getting too high right now. I think the first one is Matt Ken with 300 points at the moment, but I'm sure they will do better on their second and third ride. Let's see, Liam.
Plugging the nose. Huge! Huge! Huge bonuses. Plugging again. What's it going to be? Trying to go.
Currently, Abby in the first place with 500 points.
Holcomb going down the face and dropping in, going for that one, going for a switch. McNasty going for a McNasty in the other direction. Abby Tate.
Taking a breath. You've got this.
Mackenzie Kate is going last because she won semis, and she's currently in third position, so she's got one more run. She's the only one that could move the order, and it's gonna happen pretty soon. Let's see what she got
right now.
Pumping herself up as she drops into the feature.
Dropping in now with an entry, moving to the right hand side of the feature to set up for her first big trick. Going for a McNasty, getting plenty of air on that. Going for the McNasty the other direction, unfortunately catching a little bit of an edge on it. Unfortunately flushing, she can make it back up into the hole. She only needs to get two.
With 5 seconds left to go, big spare aerial loop. Will she flush it? She's pumping, she's still proud.
We have our final order, I believe.
We do, so topping the podium, and now our new reigning junior women's world champion, Abby Holcomb out of the USA. Our silver medalist, Neve Macken of Great Britain, and only a few points behind McKinley Kate Hargrove, one of our youngest competitors here at the World Championship, in third.
She threw down a big McNasty and then kind of got worked on the bubble and flushed. Oh, I'm so sad for her, but she's still in third place, so it's pretty good for a 14-year-old girl. Story for her.
Next up, we've got our junior men's K1 finals.
You sold your soul to the evil and the lust and the All right, Tom made the interesting choice to ask my dad to help him out with synchro freestyle, and they've got a plan. How well they stick to it without hitting each other is about to be really interesting. Ale! Cartwheel! Tom forgot how to cartwheel! Ah, oh, Tom's gonna flush! Go, 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 go! Not bad, not bad. I'm there.
One, go. I'll go. Two,
three, go. Ah! Tom, you had one job.
So, I am switching to my phone because I have no more battery on my GoPro, but it is the start of the finals. Emily is at the top and the judges are about to give her the thumbs up. And look at Parker's. Come on, Emily!
Not wasting any time in the instant, that was really high electrode plugging and looking for a huge space within the right hand side. In the car, she has a great opening left hand, and that's just a start. She goes right back to Dusty, and she's going around for a Dusty. On her way around, landing it. Come on, Emily. Free, and she pulls it for a 40-40.
Well, that was a big ride from Emily. I don't think everything counted, but that was a pretty big ride. She's gonna get the other girls on pressure for sure.
And she's on fire. Going into Magnus into the top. Taylor on the block. And she goes down. And she goes. Like that will set up another for me. I'm going for a bomb.
Well, Atali, definitely the favorite one of the competition, just pulled a 1200 foot ride, so she's definitely gonna win with that. There's no way the other girls are gonna do that. Last run for the girls, and currently Atali is still in first, Vitamin in second, and Marlin is third. Marlin is already in third, so can only throw from 1 to 2nd.
Chappie?
Alright. I said David, Dan, and Harry.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Rob?
We'll see. It's gonna be a big final, I think.
Yeah, for sure.
Wow, stressful moment for Aoife. Dane is sitting in first, then Harry second, and David third. David didn't do a great ride. I'm sure he's gonna get a better one in his next two rides, but yeah, it looks like the pressure is killing.
Going for that entry, McNasty, right off the shoulder to set up this combination. Going for the lunar orbit to the right, linking it with a cartwheel. Robert Crowe on point, getting that lunar orbit into a loop.
Yesterday after the finals, but it was unbelievable. It was crazy. Like, Dane pulled a last third ride that was insane and took the win. Then Thomas and Harry got second and third. I'm sure the other four didn't do a good ride as they wanted to, but I guess that's how it goes in competitions. You cannot always have a good ride when it matters. But yeah, it was such a sick final, like so much level. These guys were going so hard. And yeah, overall, I'm pretty stoked with my results. I got 9th in K1, which it isn't too bad because yeah, the other ones were technically better than me. And then in C1, I got 3rd. Actually pretty bummed because Dane beat me by 4 points. And so I could have got 2nd. Probably not 1st because Landon was way too ahead of us. And I also got to do scoreboarding, which was very interesting because I've never done scoreboarding before. And it was such an amazing time to see everyone again. Super cool because it's been 3 years since sort. So I was really missing the event and all that pressure and stuff around the world. The next world will be next year in Columbus, which I'm super stoked about because that's where I used to live in the US. So I'm excited because I know the wave, and this time though I will be ready for it. Yeah, I'm really hyped to get back to training again in freestyle because I don't know if you guys knew, but I was doing slalom boarding for the past 2 years, and I think since 2019 Worlds, I probably did maybe like less than 40 playboarding sesh in 3 years, so it's definitely not a lot, and I was a little rusty, but I will be back for Columbus for sure. And yeah, I will see you guys in another vlog. Thanks for watching, and peace out. Well, I actually lied to you, and I'm actually going to Norway right now.